This morning in your Bibles, I want you to turn with me the Psalms that you're quite familiar with and hear quite often is Psalms 23. Psalms 23. The title of my message this morning is Walking Through the Valley. Walking Through the Valley. David begins the psalm in the 23rd this way. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want." When you're walking through the valley, and many of us are walking through the valley even at this very hour, we spend more time in the valley than we do on the mountaintop. Because down here, life is full of problems and circumstances that keeps us in the valley. But when we are walking through the valleys of life's troubles and trials, friend, keep in mind, you need the Lord as your shepherd. You need someone to lead, direct you, and guide you. And David begins the psalm, he said, "The Lord is my shepherd because I know Him personally and I am known by Him." Because Jesus Himself said, "My sheep hear my voice, and a stranger they'll not follow." And I am the good shepherd in John 10. I am the good shepherd that giveth his life for his sheep. And David said, "I want that shepherd, and I want him to lead and direct my life." And that is why he says, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want, because he'll take care of my every need." A shepherd tends his sheep. He makes sure they are fed. He makes sure they have everything they need to sustain them in this life. And therefore, when I am walking through the valley, I know my Lord is walking right there beside me because He is my shepherd. Notice what he says in the next verse. "He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters." A sheep will not drink from a moving fountain. It needs to be still, and it needs to be a calmness. And friend, when my life, amen, has such an uproar in it, such a turmoil in it, the waters become, amen, unstable, and therefore the sheep, amen, gets unnerved. You ever have your nerves plucked? That means the water is a little rough in your life. Hello? You need to be beside still waters. And when you're beside still waters, you have a peace that you can rest assuredly that the Lord, He's right there with you, and He's going to provide a safe place in which to lay your head. He says, "He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters," for the still waters is comfort and peace that I need in the midst of the valley. He goes on, "He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me, Thy rod and Thy staff that comforts me." I want to share with you what I think this rod and staff really means. See, as believers, we have the Holy Spirit of God living within us. I mean, He brings all things to our remembrance, whatsoever the Lord has taught us, amen, by studying His Word. Friend, you'll never have peace in walking through your valley unless you get in God's Word and know the shepherd. Hello? And know that the shepherd can meet every need that is in your life this morning. He can meet every need that is in your life this morning. He says the Lord, amen, has a rod and a staff that comforts him. The Holy Spirit and His precious Word. They comfort your hearts. They lead you in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. And even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil because of that rod and that staff that comforts you. "There prepares the table before me in the presence of my enemies. There anoints my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." One good news this morning. You'll never stay in the valley. Amen. Because as a child of God, He's going to take you to the mountaintop in which all of us should be striving to get, and that is heaven. I'm striving, amen, for that mountaintop while I'm walking through my valley. But while I'm walking through my valley, I see some things that will help me get through. I mean, tell you, sometimes trouble comes and it comes hard, doesn't it? And it looks like when it rains, it pours. How many of you have been going through things this week, amen? And how many of you have been walking through the valley or even walking right now? Perhaps maybe you said, well, everything is cool in my life. I'm just okie-dokie. Let me tell you, something's going to happen this week. It always, amen, comes about because, see, the Bible tells me that we are prone to have trouble in our life. We are creatures of crisis. Some of you say, no, I don't believe you. Yes, we are. Let me prove it to you. Job. Job 14:1. The book we like to stare at because it says Job. Job 14:1 says that a man that is born of a woman is of a few days, and then he's full of trouble. Now let me just go a little step further, ladies. It's mankind in general he's speaking. Men and women alike, not just men. I know you're saying the men are trouble in here. They're full of trouble. I know that. But I'm an angel. Come on. We all are trouble. And not with just three quarters full of trouble, we always, the Bible said we're full of trouble. Not 99.9, but we're 100% trouble. Thank you. We're full of trouble. So we're prone for crisis, amen? We're accidentally looking for a place to happen. Man, trouble is going to come our way. We ain't got to look for it. It's just going to come. It's going to come. But the way we handle it is the most important. We can be an overcomer or we can be defeated. Now, trouble is going to come in many fashions. Crises are going to roll. The valley is going to come. It comes in finance. It comes in job loss. It comes in heartaches, misery, pain, suffering, illness. It goes on and on and on and on. But all of these are valleys that you and I are confronted with in this life that we're living. And the Bible says we can either be defeated or we can be overcomers. And I'm planning on overcoming. I don't know about you, but I'm going to overcome by the grace and help of the Lord. Because first of all, the Lord says, when I'm walking through the valley, always remember that His grace is sufficient. His grace is sufficient. Sufficient for what? To sustain us while we're walking through this valley of troubles and heartaches and circumstances. His grace is sufficient. And the thing that we got to remember is, folks, that we need to be content with what God has placed in our lives. Be content with it. How can you be content with some illness that has come upon you? Friend, turn it over to the Lord. Cast all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. Paul had an illness, amen, within his body. But you know what God told him in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7 through 10? Paul begins to address this. He had an illness, and remember this. And he says, let me get my glasses. At least I should be exalted above measures through the abundance of revelation that were given to me, a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buff me. Least I should be exalted above measures. For this thing I besought the Lord three times that He might depart from me. He says, look, there's something that came in my life. I hit a pothole. Everything was going along. I thought was smooth sailing. I was preaching. I was sharing the gospel. I was taking stones, amen, for what people was throwing at me. I've been beaten and all. My life was good. I mean, I was doing what I thought God wanted me to do. And all of a sudden, something struck me. I hit a pothole of illness within my life. And he said, you know, I prayed to God. I prayed to God to remove it. But I have found out whatever state I am is to be content. And when I sought God to remove this ailment from me, because see, if he'd have done it himself, if he'd have done some great thing, and he took care of it himself, then he said, I would have boasted myself. I would put myself upon a pedestal. And I said, look what I've done. But he said, it wasn't that simple. He said, this was brought and to be effective in my life for a reason. He said, I sought the Lord 3 times to remove it. And he says, the Lord told me, I'm not going to remove it. I'm not going to touch it. My grace is sufficient for thee. When you are weak, I am strong. When you are weak, I am strong. You've got to learn to deal with it and know that I am right there by your side. I am your shepherd, and you shall not want. His grace is sufficient to sustain us through anything that we are going through in life. And the quicker we learned it, the more the valley, amen, seemed more pleasant to walk in. Are you with me today, church? My grace is sufficient. Listen to what he says in the rest of that. I'll read it. For these things I besought the Lord 3 times, threats that he might depart from me. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, Paul said, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasures in infirmities, in reproach, in necessities, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake, for I am weak, then I am strong. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I am strong. And listen, he says, I'm going to be content. Philippians chapter 4 there in 11 through 13. He says, now I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatsoever state I am. Therewith be content. I know both how to be abased and I know how to be abound everywhere. And in all things, I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. There's not a problem that me and the Lord can't handle. Because I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. If you're walking through the valley, know God's grace is sufficient. Second of all, knowing that you can achieve. And you can be an overcomer, amen, in any obstacle that is in your way. Philippians 4:13, my favorite verse. I can. Don't mean I can't, I can, amen. Oh, I can quit. It didn't say that. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. His standard is absolute performance and obedience to all he commands. He demands results, not excuses. From you and I, as believers in him, we are not to make excuse, but to say we can overcome any obstacle there's in our life's path. Because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Remember, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. Whenever we depend upon God, when we're walking through the valley, our soul is restored. If you restore something, what you do? Make it new. It restores, amen? When, you know, the devil might beat you up, amen, in the valley. He might whoop up on you. But turn the tables around, whoop up on him. Say, greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. Satan, you're not going to get me down, amen? Because God is going to pick me up no matter what I'm going through. Because when I am weak, he is strong. He is strong. I like what Dr. Falwell used to quote quite often. He said, you don't determine your greatness by the talents or the wealth that you possess, but by rather what it takes to discourage you and make you quit. Because, see, our problems when we're walking through the valley is oftentimes we want to throw in the towel and quit and not depend upon God's greatness, His strength, and to help us and sustain us through the tough times. We want to quit. We want to quit. It's easy to quit. We see people all the time quitting the church. We see pastors quitting the pastorate and going out and saying, forget it, it's not worth it. Listen, friend, everything we do for Christ is worth it. Over and over again. Nothing that you and I will do, amen, in this life is none value if we do it in Christ. Amen? If we do it in Christ. But today's problem is we got a lot of quitters. No committed people. They're not committed in their relationship with one another because they're not committed with God. Come on. Come on, we need to turn it around. And if they're not committed, amen, with God in their relationship, they're not committed to their relationship personally, they're not going to be committed to the church or anything else. So we got to have people who are committed, amen, to the Lord and stick through it, even though the potholes come quite frequently. It's a stick through it. But let me tell you, the closer you get to God, the closer you get to God, the more the potholes are going to come. Have anybody drove on potholes, run into them on the roadway? If you hadn't lately, go up Rivermont Avenue. The road of life is like that sometimes. They come one right after the other. You can't stand much more. Listen, friend, amen, we got to look to God and realize that God is riding with us in life. He's right there beside us. And when we can't make it anymore, let Him, amen, lift us up. Let Him tote our load. Like the footprints in the sand. When there was only one set of footprints is when the Lord was carrying us. Listen, let Him carry you through the tough times. Do not quit because quitters never win. Quitters never win. Not here on earth, not in eternity. Quitters never win. Matter of fact, amen, Jesus Himself said, Luke 9:62, Jesus said unto him, no man having put his hand to the plow and look it back is fit for the kingdom of God. So we can't look back, and we can't quit. My eyes is on the mountaintop. Where is yours today? Is it looking at all the circumstances in the valley, or is it looking, amen, unto the author and finisher of your faith? Now, you said that's easier said than done. Because the older you get, anybody getting older? You might not think you are, but let me break the bad news to you. You are. I guarantee you won't as pretty as yesterday when you looked in that mirror as you were this morning. And you won't be tomorrow. As we get older, it seems like it's more complicated sometimes to handle the trials and the circumstances that come in our life. Sometimes we get frenzies, I guess what I'm looking for. Or we get, man, how am I going to do this? We get fidgety. We get unnerved, you know. Our nerves, man, it's... The older I get, I found out too, dealing with children. The kids get older. Oh man, it's just something, you know. I mean, you ever had just one nerve left, and somebody got on that, you know? We get in a tizzy, and we don't know what to do. Then we're looking for aids. We start out with Kool-Aid. Then we have to get Rolaids, hearing aids. Medicaid, Band-Aids, I've got to have all kind of aids. Why not, amen, say, Lord, I need an aid. I need Jesus to aid me in this, amen. I'm at my wit's end, and I need some help, Lord. You know, you have not because you asked not. You heard that. That's what the Word says. We have not. You know, we try to handle things our own, and it's too big for us because we can't handle it. You know why? Because we are peeping through the peephole of life. Anybody remember the skeleton key locks? They're in the historical museum for the younger generation. It was a skeleton key you put in a hole and you could peep through the hole. It's like peeping through the crack of the door. Let me step further for the younger crowd. Have you got to ever look through one of them peepholes in your door so you can see somebody on the outside? Anybody with me today? I mean, I know it's getting 12 o'clock. I mean, I'm going to let you go in just a minute. But you can only see what's in that viewfinder. You can't see with the left or right of it. You only can see what's in front of you. And that's the way we peep through life a lot of times. We're peeping through the peephole of life, and we can only see what's in front of us. Why not turn it over to someone who sees all the picture? Amen. The front, the back, and the middle. Amen. And what's in the future? And that's Jesus Christ. Amen. He knows where He brought you from. He knows where you're at right now. He knows where He wants to take you to. Why not trust Him? He created you. Who knows more about you than the one who made you? Created you in His image. My friend today, He knows your thoughts that you're thinking right at this hour. And some of you in never land. Some of you are thinking about what you're going to do when the preacher says amen, the final amen. And let me tell you, some of you are thinking about, Lord, I wish He shut up. You know, God is recording all of that. God is recording that. He knows what you're thinking at this hour. He knows what's troubling you. He knows what's ailing you. Why not give Him an opportunity to aid you in your circumstances this morning? His grace is sufficient, and you can overcome by the biblical achievement verse, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ. Don't quit, because quitters never win, and winners never quit. The quicker we learn that, the more we realize, hey man, if we quit on God down here, guess what? When we stand up there, He's going to quit on us. Come on, He said, if you deny Me before men down here, I'll deny you before the Father. So, hello, stay committed, amen, to what you believe in. What do you believe this morning? I believe that Jesus Christ died for me. He loved me when I was unlovable. When I was yet a sinner, Christ died for me. He loved me that much. And He paid a sin debt that I couldn't pay. And all I got to do is put my trust in Him and ask Him to forgive me of my sins. And He covers that sin with His precious blood. Way it'll never be remembered, amen, before the Father again. He gives me a new start. He gives me a new beginning. Why would I want to serve Him, amen? Why wouldn't I want to serve Him? He's done everything for me. He's going to be with me through the tough times of my life. When the storms are raging in my life, He's going to be the one who calms them. Not the doctors, not the lawyers, not anything in this world. It's the Lord Jesus who brings me to the still water that I may drink and have peace while I'm walking through the valley. Because that peace comes from knowing where I'm heading to, the mountaintop. Where are you going this morning? Are you going to turn it over to Him? Are you going to trust Him? Are you going to walk through the valley with the mully grubs, as the old folks said? Mully grubs are something terrible. I don't know what it is, but you don't want to get them, because that's something the old folks say, there is something you don't want to have. That's where your chin is hanging down to the ground. You thinking nobody loves you, nobody cares for you, and life ain't worth living. It is worth living, because I got the life giver on my side.
Life is easy. Up on the mountain, you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. when life's at its best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptations. That's where faith is really put to the test. For the God on the
Thank you for joining us this morning. New Beginning Tabernacle is located at 1886 South Coolwell Road in Madison Heights, Virginia. You can visit us on the web at nbtministries.org. If you would like to support our broadcast, please give us a call or write to us at P.O. Box 449, Madison Heights, Virginia 24572. Hope to see you soon, and God bless you.